Our statement of faith this morning comes from the Presbyterian's Confession of 1967. We only have about a dozen statements of faith that we've officially adopted. And if you think of the tumultuous times in 1967, the church felt like it needed to make a declaration, a proclamation of who we are as Christians. So let us speak of the fulfillment of reconciliation. God's redeeming order in Jesus Christ embraces the whole of life of humankind, social and cultural, economic and political, scientific and technological, individual and corporate. It includes the natural environment of humans as exploited and despoiled by sin. It is the will of God that God's purpose for human life shall be fulfilled under the rule of Christ, and all evil be banished from God's creation. Biblical visions and images of the rule of Christ, such as the heavenly city, a father's house, a new heaven and earth, a marriage feast, and an unending day, culminate in the image of the kingdom. The kingdom represents the triumph of God over all that resists God's will and disrupts God's creation. Already, God's reign is present as a ferment in the world, stirring hope in humankind and preparing the world to receive its ultimate judgment and redemption. With an urgency born of this hope, the church applies itself to present tasks and strives for a better world. It does not identify limited progress with the kingdom of God on earth, nor does it despair in the face of disappointment and defeat. In steadfast hope, the church looks beyond all partial achievement to the final triumph of God. Now to him, by the power at work within us, is able to do far more abundantly than all we ask or think. To him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. We have given a portion of that which has God has given to us. And so how can we help but seek God's praise? Let us sing the doxology. For the banishment of the terrorism just peace. We pray, O God, for the people of Rafa, who live in the Gaza Strip. We pray for brakes, O Lord, on vehicles and weapons of destruction that would destroy their homes and place their lives in harm's way. In the name of the Prince of Peace, O God, we pray for peace in the land walked by him. We pray for neighbors, workmates, friends, family, strangers, and we even pray for enemies who are in the throes of hardship, suffering, or grief today. Bless your representatives who reach out to them with transfiguring encouragement, and where appropriate, please recruit us among those who serve. We pray for the church in many lands and under diverse conditions, especially where it lives under political or social intimidation. Bless your people wherever they gather in the name of Christ Jesus, and enable them to persist and transfigure adverse conditions to your glory. Encourage each of us according to our needs. Equip all according to the challenges of this new week, and bless all with your grace which knows no bounds and transfigures all circumstances, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. In Highland today at our Yoke Church, there were numerous scouts who attended to celebrate Scout Sunday, and so we sang Taps. And this is often played at the services of our veterans. We hear this at those funerals, but we don't always hear the words. So let us sing together. Day is done.
Oh,
still clothed. None of us are naked. We still wear the garments that take hold of our lives. We still have a baton. So as we go from this place, let us go in full force before we reach that exchange zone. Let us go with the grace of God, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the comfort of the Holy Spirit. For we are God's children.